Hey guys, today I'll teach how to make a bird that flaps the wings using a mechanical system. And this project is not very hard because the materials are very easy to find and you're probably going to have all in home. Yeah, so let's get started. To make the bird, you're going to need the printer paper and start by folding in order to make an isosceles triangle. Crisp well the line and after cut the rectangle using a pair of scissors. When you're going to open the triangle, you're going to see that you have a perfect square. You have to do another diagonal that intersects with the first one at 90 degrees. Turn the paper like this and after fold it in half. Push with your finger in the middle of the square and after you have to do the triangle how you see in the video. Now, fold this line on top of this line here carefully and after crisp well. To finish this side, we have to fold this part on top of this as well. Turn the bird for other side and do the same thing. I use this bird for this project, but you can use another ones that you can find on the internet. Have a lot of different models for these birds that flap the wings, that you can use as well. Fold the triangle like this in order that the line that starts on the tail have to continue still there. Now you have to do as you are watching. It's not very difficult, but I can explain you using my English, sorry guys. To do the beak of the bird, you have to do practically the same thing that you did on the neck. And after that, the bird is done. Now, I'm going to start making the base of this machine, and for that I used popsicle sticks, but if you don't have, don't worry. You can use pencils, rulers, cardboard or other materials that can support this bird. The length of this support have to be 5-4 cm bigger than the length of the bird. So guys, this is my second tutorial that I speak in English and I have to say thank you for all people that correct me in the last video. That is very important for me and helped me a lot. And yeah, and if someone going to find something wrong that I say here, you can leave in the comments and I'm going to try to improve for the next tutorial. Yes, so let's continue. I removed the switch and the motor from a mini fan, but if you don't want to pay for that, you can find that easily in an old toy. Now, glue the motor in the junction of these two parts. Try to don't glue the switch very close to the motor, leave about 5-4 cm. If you are using a motor from a mini fan like me, you're probably going to need a little bit extra wire. If your motor don't come with a small pulley, you have to do one. And the easiest way to do that is cut a small cylinder and wire in the middle using sandpaper. Now you're going to need two caps with two different sizes. And you have to do holes in the middle and after add together using glue. To make the holes, I used a craft knife. In this part, you're going to need to make two cardboard circles, and to measure that, you can use a paper tube from the toilet. Using a barbecue stick, you have to do a hole in the middle of the circles, and after glue in which way of the caps. Now make a hole in the place that you see in the video and put glue inside, a lot of glue. And after put the barbecue stick there or something like that and leave to dry. When it will be dry, you have to cut and leave about 2 cm. After, you have to drill a hole to put the shaft of the pulley. In this part, you're going to need a small cylinder that have about 1 cm, 1.5 cm, that I cut from a pen using a metal axle. You're going to need as well a small rubber band and a small piece from a popsicle stick. Next, you have to do an axis in this part of the support. And you're going to need as well 2 small circles. And to make it, I used a bottle closer for reference. And you have to leave a distance from about 1 cm, 1.5 cm between these 2 circles. This project is practically done. Now you have to tie the string to the tube, fix with glue to don't go out. After, you have to put the bird on top of the structure, and you have to use a lot of glue to be strong the connection, okay? And finally, you have to tie the string, the end of the string, to the tail, and you have to play a little bit with the size till this work. So guys, this is the end of the tutorial, and I have to say thank you so much for watching this. And if you have some suggestion, you can leave in the comments, I will read. And I'm going to try to do some of that stuff later. Yeah, so thanks for watching again, bye! Thank you.